UK equities have opened on the back foot after US equity markets eased yesterday, while Asian markets retreated this morning after disappointing Chinese PMI services data. Now let's talk about the companies in the news today. Tullow Oil defies the trend, rising more than 3% after an upbeat trading update. With high-quality production continuing to underpin our financial position, we are well-placed for the remainder of this year and into 2014, said Tullow's chief executive, Aidan Heavey. And investors had little appetite, however, for Domino's Pizza, despite the company boasting a 6.1% increase in like-for-like sales in the 13 weeks to the end of June. The growth rate represents a slowdown from the first quarter and left like-for-like growth in the first half of 2013 at 6.4%. Domino noted that the performance was achieved despite very strong comparative figures from the second quarter of last year. But the market was unconvinced and took a slice out of the share price. Broker recommendations have given a lift to gold firm Randgold Resources and chip designer Arm Holdings. The former has been upgraded to neutral by Citigroup, and the latter has been bumped up to buy by UBS. Amur Minerals is up after it revealed encouraging early-stage drill results from the Kubik nickel-copper prospect within the Kunmani license. The company revealed initial discovery holes have found near-surface mineralization with substantial thickness and better-than-average grades. Amur explained that the mineralization, which is shallowly dipping, is more favorable for open-pit mining. The thickest intercepts were encountered at depths of up to 100 meters, it said. And drilling results were also the reason for early demand for Avocet mining shares. The stock price rose after the company encountered what it calls a significant intercepts during infilling drilling at its 3K development in Guinea. Whilst the full impact of these intersections will not be fully known until this drilling is incorporated in the 3K mineral resource estimate, these results are nonetheless excellent, said David Cather, Chief Executive Officer of Avocet. And drug developer Summit was also on the climb as institutional investors paid a premium to get their hands on a chunk of new shares. The company is raising £4.5 million via a placing and open offer of stock at a near 18% premium to last night's closing share price. The cash injection will be used to fund the development of its potentially breakthrough treatment of Duchenne muscular dystrophy, the fatal muscle wasting disease that affects boys. And Petrochelting International said that Italian oil giant Eni is working to identify a new location for the Carpignano-Sesia well on the Carrizio permit in the Po Valley in Italy. Eni will use all the latest technologies to identify a location that allows all well objectives to be achieved, but also meets local stakeholders' concerns that the operation was too close to the village of Carpignano-Sesia. Eni and Petrochelting each own a 47.5% stake in the permit. EMED Mining's navigation of the bureaucratic labyrinth that is the pathway to the reopening of the historic Rio Tinto copper mine in southern Spain has been slow and steady. But the company has made another baby step closer to its goal as it revealed public affirmation of its timetable for the mining restart by the Andalusian Minister for Industry. Elsewhere in the mining sector, Premier African Minerals said that the $2.4 million Canadian dollars all paper deal to sell its Togo and Mali subsidiaries to Ethiopian Potash was approved at the company's annual meeting recently. The transaction now only requires TSX Venture Exchange final approval. And that's it for the news today, Wednesday, the 3rd of July.